Mike Moore Media, the first place to hear Rockingham County news and information.
Our program is sponsored by Cone Health and today's Annie Penn Hospital. So advanced is so close to home. ConeHealth.com. Rezoning was a hot topic at the Stoneville Town Council meeting last night, and the people spoke. The Planning and Zoning Board already approved rezoning property at Lemons and East Main Street to Business Highway for Chuck and Jake Hundley to construct storage buildings, a project they've been working on for about 5 years. Seven people appeared before council, all speaking against it. Barbara Lachlan said it's a stupid place to put it. She's concerned about the noise, light, and strange people coming into the neighborhood. Lance Messick cited problems with water runoff, increased traffic, more congestion, and bringing down property values. Robert Aldridge agreed, saying it's a bad idea. Rex Tuggle said it would be an eyesore coming into town. It's residential all around. Everyone's against it, asking, is this what's really needed in Stoneville, or what a few individuals want because it would put money in their pockets? He told the board, you need to listen to the people. The property owners spoke. Councilman Chuck Hundley reminded his fellow councilman, Planning and Zoning has already approved it. The project met all four criteria to rezone, and two properties across the street are already rezoned Business Highway. He also mentioned economic growth at zero cost to the town. Jake Hundley said, with a 60-year reputation in the business community, he never thought there would be such a negative reaction from friends and customers. He said not a single person has mentioned it to him, and he wondered where people are getting their information. It may or may not be correct. Counting personal comments, letters, and emails, 40 residents have made it clear they're against the rezoning. The vote, Bill Ferris and Camp Thornton, yes. Johnny Farmer and Jerry Smith, no. A tie. Councilman Hundley recused himself. Mayor Kathy Galvin was the tiebreaker, and she voted no, saying when elected, she promised to do what's best, fair, and beneficial for the town. Stoneville Town Hall reopens to the public tomorrow, using only the front entrance. Everyone must wear masks and practice social distancing. The city of Reidsville is having a community prayer vigil on the steps of the police department on West Moorhead Street tomorrow at noon. Everyone is welcome using social distancing guidelines. Special countywide event, Unity in Peace and Prayer, tomorrow starting at 6 p.m. at John E. Grogan Park at Eden City Hall on East Stadium Drive, and traveling to the Rockingham County Sheriff's Office, Reidsville, Madison, Mayodan, and Stoneville Police Departments, observing social distancing guidelines with a maximum of 25 people for an outside gathering. Parking at the Moorhead High School football stadium entrance. The group will leave Eden and go to other agencies around the county in groups of 25 or less, continuing COVID-19 guidelines and encouraging protective masks. The purpose of the event, to pray for a hedge of protection around local law enforcement officers and for peace in our county and country. You are always welcome at Lane's Family Pharmacy. Stop in, talk with the Lane's family about your home medical needs. They have a big selection, everything from nebulizers to support hosiery. Need to speak to a pharmacist personally? Keith and Kevin Lane are there to help you and answer any questions about medications and recommend over-the-counter items. Lane's also has a bargain section filled with $1 specials like kitchen and bathroom cleaning supplies, items from A to Z, aluminum foil to Ziploc bags. Lots of good deals. Lane's is open Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m., and Saturday, 9 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. Lane's is well known for their countywide delivery service. Call 336-627-4600. Lane's Family Pharmacy is on NC 14 Eden, near the hospital. Now, Rockingham County weather. Today, sunny and hot, high 91, Tonight, clear, low 67. Thursday, mostly sunny, high 89. Friday and Saturday, a 40% chance of scattered showers, high 87. Sunday, mostly sunny, high 86. Get current weather information anytime at mikemore.media, along with Rocking Cam, our live stream weather camera, sponsored by Heat and Air Controllers, for year-round comfort, whatever the weather. Need a tow? Dave's Towing is a call away, 24 hours a day, at this number, 336-932-7478.
Quicken Loans presents the Sports Flash, driven by Jeep on Mike Moore Media. NBA insider Adrian Wojnarowski on ESPN Tuesday has more on the NBA's efforts to create a plan to return to action.
Regular season games, play-in games, and then the playoffs, and the last possible date that teams have been now informed of for the NBA Finals, Game 7 would be on that October 12th, and teams are now planning to be in Orlando in July, start at their own practice facilities, and then move down for a more formal training camp later in July with that July 31 tip-off in Orlando.
22 teams would play under the proposal at Disney's Wide World of Sports complex. The NBA Board of Governors expected to approve the proposal this Thursday. No monthly payments for 90 days, 0% APR for 84 months. Details at Jeep.com. That's your Sports Flash, driven by Jeep. Chuck Sanders, Mike Moore Media.
We're here to tell you about Boost Mobile's new upgraded network.
That's right. Stronger signal, faster speeds, and more coverage.
So now you can get everything you want faster, like Pitbull's music.
No, the new upgraded network means you can download music faster than ever before. It doesn't mean that it will make Pitbull songs faster.
Oh, so this isn't the song.
No, this is the song.
Well, this is embarrassing.
Step up with Boost Mobile's new upgraded network. Stronger signal, faster speeds, more coverage than before. Switch and get four unlimited lines for $25 per line per month and four free LG K51 phones. Access to upgraded network requires compatible device. New customers only. Four-line offer requires at least one port and activation from eligible carrier. Free phone limited to one per line while supplies last. Customers using more than 35 gigabytes of data during billing cycle may be deprioritized during times of congestion. Offers and coverage not available everywhere. Additional terms and restrictions apply. See BoostMobile.com or retailer for full details.
In our business spotlight today, Eden's Own Journal, Rockingham County Star, free at over 130 locations countywide and online at edensown.com. The June edition is available now. Here's today's Consumer Report.
Pier 1 Imports, once a mainstay of shopping malls across America, is closing its doors for good, going out of business in October. The home goods chain has been losing market share to competitors for years, and the sales blow it suffered during the COVID-19 outbreak was just too much. Pharmaceutical giant Eli Lilly has announced the first clinical trial of a new drug made from antibodies taken from patients who have recovered from the coronavirus. The drug takes advantage of the molecular defenses developed by recovered patients that fights the virus and other infections. The coronavirus lockdown was apparently good for the streaming business. A poll by CreditCards.com shows consumers increased audio and video streaming subscriptions by 31% this spring. Millennials drove the increase, with 43% saying they added a service in March through April. I'm Mark Huffman. Learn more at ConsumerAffairs.com.
Today we're celebrating National Egg Day, National Running Day, National Chocolate Macaroon Day. Oh, that sounds good. And it's National Repeat Day. National Repeat Day. National Repeat Day. We get it. Okay, today in history, 1539, Hernando de Soto claimed Florida for Spain. 1621, the Dutch West India Company received a charter for New Netherlands, now known as New York. 1784, Congress formally created the United States Army to replace the disbanded Continental Army. 1851, the New York Knickerbockers became the first baseball team to wear uniforms. 1933, The State magazine debuted, still a favorite as Our State. Close to home, June 3, 1985. Fritz Klinner of Reidsville, his cousin Susie Newsom Lynch, and her three sons died as their car, loaded with guns, poison, and a bomb, exploded on the highway near Greensboro. Jerry Bledsoe's book, Bitter Blood, was a bestseller. A total of 9 people died. Big-name birthdays: Anderson Cooper, 52, Michelle Keegan, 32, Denise Williams and Susie Quattro, 69. A couple of big-name birthdays, bell ringer birthdays today. Charles Archer, longtime employee at Rockingham County Radio. Thank you, Charles, for your many years of service, your loyalty. And Shelby Ryan, president of the Rockingham County Tennis Association. Thank you, Shelby, for your good work. Got a birthday coming up? Text it to 336-932-1881. In our music spotlight today, how about some big band music? The Righteous Brothers had a hit with this song in 1965. But here's the original, Unchained Melody, a number one song for Les Baxter in 1955.
Unchained.
Nice. Lots of people have recorded that song over the years. Let's finish with our motivational moment. Let everyone sweep in front of his own door, and the whole world will be clean. Thanks for listening. Make it a wonderful Wednesday, friends, and remember to count your blessings.